Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Tayyiba Farhad. In this particular series, we are going to learn logic programming using Prolog and Sublime. So if you want to learn how to download and install Prolog and Sublime, then continue watching the video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, click on the bell icon and hit the like button so you don't miss any upcoming video. So let's get started. If you want to download Prolog, then just go to the official website of Prolog, and here you can see multiple options for versions for different operating systems, and you are required to download the appropriate version according to your operating system. I'm using Windows 10 64-bit, so I'm going to download the 64-bit Windows 10 version for Prolog. Once your downloading is started, it will take a while to download the software depending upon the internet speed. After the downloading is completed, you click on the exe file and click on the next button until the software is being installed. After the installation, open Prolog and see the question mark blinking. This is indicating that the Prolog is working fine, and now you can write your logical statement, your effects and your queries here. Similar to the Prolog, you need to install Sublime Text in your system to write all the facts and rules into the Sublime Text and execute queries in Prolog. So you need to go to the official website of Sublime Text. Here you can see multiple versions for multiple operating system, and just like Prolog, you need to install the relative version according to your operating system. I have Windows 10 64-bit, so I'm going to install the 64-bit Sublime Text version, and after the downloading is completed, click on the exe file and click on the next button so you can install Sublime Text in your operating system. After the installation is completed, you will see Sublime Text in this format. In the upcoming video, you are going to see how we can connect Sublime Text with the Prolog, where we will write all of our facts and rules in Sublime and write the queries into Prolog to execute logical programming. So that's all for today. If you have any query or you want to share some thoughts, just write in the comment box. I will answer to all of the comments, and it's always good to have two-way communication. If you like the video, click on the like button, subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so you don't miss any upcoming video on Prolog or logic programming. Share it with your friends so our community, our circle can grow. Bye bye.